Hello everyone, welcome. It's time to test Red Dead Redemption on our entry-level GPU, the GTX 1050 with only 2 GB of VRAM. If we had difficulties running Zelda Tears of the Kingdom at native resolution, will we be able to do the same with Red Dead Redemption? That's what you're going to find out now. But before we proceed, remember that if you want to stay updated in the world of emulation and follow the tests of the latest releases on various emulators, don't forget to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to receive new content every week.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
If we tried to run Red Dead Redemption on the GTX 1050 using Xenia, we would certainly have a quite unsatisfactory experience. The emulator requires at least the GTX 980, which offers up to 40% better performance at 1080p resolution compared to the GTX 1050. So, for those who have this GPU, the option was indeed to wait for the game to be released on other platforms. Since the PlayStation 4 emulator, FPPS4, is still far from running 3D games, we turned to Nintendo Switch emulators. Even though Rockstar disappointed by not releasing a 13-year-old game natively on PC, emulation still presents itself as an alternative, and in this case, we used Yuzu and Ryujinx. Before we begin our test, it's important to talk about the hardware we're using. The entire system is based on components released in 2017, which can be considered outdated by today's standards, especially in terms of the GPU. We're using an i7-8700K processor paired with a GTX 1050, in its basic version with only 2 GB of VRAM. No overclocking has been applied to the components. We'll test both emulators, Yuzu and Ryujinx, with unlocked FPS and see what resolution we can achieve. The complete specifications used in the emulators will be available in the video description if you want more details. The first test was conducted at native resolution, with BC1 texture compression in Yuzu and active texture compression in Ryujinx. Remember that the game is locked at 65 FPS by Rockstar and, at the moment, there's no mod to bypass this limitation. If you still have visual issues with either of these emulators, I recommend updating to the latest versions, as most of the issues have been fixed. The route chosen for the test is mostly through open areas, starting and ending in dense cities. After about 3 minutes of testing, we obtained the following results. Using Yuzu, the average was 49 FPS, with a minimum of 33 and a maximum of 64, and 25 FPS in the low 1%. I noticed that Yuzu uses the GPU less but doesn't provide a significant performance boost. Additionally, the VRAM usage is about 25% higher, which could be problematic considering we're using a system with limited VRAM by today's standards. On the other hand, Ryujinx showed a considerably higher average, with 56 FPS, a minimum of 32, a maximum of 65, and 27 FPS in the low 1%. Gameplay seems smoother, and frame times are more stable on Ryujinx. For me, it's clear that in this test, Ryujinx performed significantly better than Yuzu, offering higher frame rates throughout most of the route. But we're not stopping here. Let's now push the limits of this GPU using the 1440p resolution. Can we achieve at least 65 FPS? We repeated the same route, and the results were as follows. In Yuzu, the average was 38 FPS, with a minimum of 30 FPS and a maximum of 47 FPS, and a result of 17 FPS in the low 1%. GPU usage didn't go beyond 60%, and the CPU reached only 42% usage at some moments. Using Ryujinx, we obtained the following results, an average of 43 FPS, a minimum of 33, a maximum of 53 FPS, with a result of 30 FPS in the low 1%. In the case of Ryujinx, the GPU was utilized to the maximum, reaching 98% usage, but there was better utilization compared to Yuzu, resulting in more FPS during the route. Additionally, the CPU performed better due to the higher frame rate provided by the emulator. What caught the most attention in this 1440p test was the frame time. If we look at the Yuzu side, the frame time is completely off the line, showing significant variation. For those who have been following the channel for a while, you know that Ryujinx had frame time issues before, and it was advised to disable VSync in Ryujinx and enable it in the GPU manager. However, this has been fixed, and today it has a more stable frame time than Yuzu. So, once again, due to better utilization of all the hardware, Ryujinx demonstrated superior performance. Attempts were made to run the game at 4K, but right at the main menu, the game showed graphical artifacts, so I decided to stop the tests. This is due to the fact that this GPU has a history of causing crashes when its VRAM is fully utilized. Do you agree with my opinion? Which of the emulators presented better results on your PC? Leave your thoughts in the comments. And thus, we conclude the video of our comparison using entry-level hardware. Would you like more games to be tested on this GPU? Thank you for watching, and until the next video.
Well, you never tried to save me before. You only seemed to save yourself.